Good morning, student. Today we are going to start a new chapter. Chapter name is that ammonia, NH3, we know that the structure of ammonia already we have discussed. N has 3 covalent bond which is attached with the hydrogen. It has 3 single bond and it has 1 lone pair electron, and because of that lone pair electron it behaves as a Lewis base. I think it is very new for you. Actually, in a previous chapter you have discussed about the acids are those substances which have tendency to lose lone pair, hydrogen ion on dissociation in water, and basically are those substances which give OH ion, but it is a Lewis base. How? Actually, whatever you have discussed in a previous chapter, it was the Arrhenius theory. It is a Lewis base. The Lewis base, a compound which have tendency to lose one lone pair electron, at least one lone pair electron, that is called Lewis base. And acid, the compound which have tendency to gain a lone pair electron, that is called Lewis acid. So it is Lewis base. It is acting as a Lewis base, and you can see the structure. It has 3 pair of bonding electron, 3 bond pair electron, and 1 lone pair electron. It is very clear from the structure, and it is present 3 state. First one, gaseous state. Second one, liquid state, liquid ammonia, liquid. It is prepared by the pressurizing the gaseous state. When we apply the pressure, it will be liquefied. And third one is that liquor ammonia. It is prepared by the destructive distillation of wood or charcoal. You will get the liquor ammonia. So these are the state, and it was first prepared by the Joseph Priestley in 1775, and the composition of ammonia was determined by the Berthelot in 1785, and it is given in your Frank book 182 pages. So you can see that. And now today we talk about the preparation, laboratory preparation, and some other experiment in which we will get the ammonia gas. So first, I think all of you have felt the smell of the ammonia. It is a very pungent smell. Pungent smell. When you are going in toilet, you can feel the very bad smell is coming out. It happens due to presence of ammonia. You know ammonia, how it is formed from the urine? We know that urine contains urea. Its formula is that C double bond O, NH2, NH2. And already we have discussed about the urea. And then it decomposes, will get what we will get? NH3, H2O, and carbon dioxide gas. And because of presence of this gas, we are feeling very bad smell because of ammonia gas. So from the urea, also on the decomposition, we will get the ammonia. So now today we'll talk about the preparation of ammonia. The first one, we can prepare ammonia from any ammonium salt, any ammonium salt, but we'll discuss later why we cannot use all ammonium salt. I'll let you know. First, I'll take ammonium chloride. It will react with calcium hydroxide. It is called silicate lime. acids react with that, we will get NH3, calcium chloride, and we'll get the water. You can balance the equation. How many nitrogen is there? 1. You can see calcium is 1, balance. Chlorine is 2. Just put 2 here. Then after putting 2, you will get a 2 nitrogen. Put 2 here. Then count the hydrogen. 2, 4, 8, and 2, 10, 6, 2. You will get the balance equation. Also, you can prepare the NH4, SO4, ammonium sulfate by reacting KOH. Similarly, we will get K2SO4 and NH3, and again we will get the what? Water. Balance it. 2K is there, putting 2. N is 2, here 2. How many hydrogen is there? 4, 2 is 8. 2 equations balance. Similarly, you can prepare NH4Cl react with NaOH. What we will get? We will get NH3, NaCl, and plus H2O. In all these cases, we are getting ammonia gas. Here we are getting. But in laboratory, we are using only this method. Why? Because KOH or NaOH is a deliquescent in nature. Deliquescent means it can absorb the water and change into the moist. That's why in the laboratory preparation, we cannot use KOH and NaOH. That's why we must use calcium hydroxide, because it is not deliquescent. Deliquescent means absorb the water and change into the sticky substances or moisture. That is called deliquescent. So that's why it is not used. It may be asked, in the preparation of ammonia, we can take the ammonium salt. And why we cannot use the KOH and NaOH? We are using only calcium hydroxide because of this reason. And also, I have said that we can prepare the ammonia from any ammonium salt. So we can also use ammonium hydroxide. Can you prepare from this? No. Actually, it is a very expensive, and other way, it is a explosive in nature. So this chemical, this ammonium hydroxide, ammonium nitrate, NH4NO3, we cannot use, because ammonium nitrate, not the hydroxide, we cannot take the ammonium nitrate because it is explosive in nature, and on the heating, it will decompose into N2O and we get the H2O. And you can balance it. How many hydrogens are there? 1 and 1, 2. 2 balance. Of hydrogen is how many? 4. Just putting 2, you get the balance equation. You can get in the N2O. So from the ammonium nitrate, we cannot prepare the ammonia gas. So it may be asked in an examination, two things, why we cannot use KOH and NaOH for preparation of ammonia, and why we cannot prepare the ammonia from the ammonium nitrate, because it is an explosive in nature. So now, in the laboratory preparation, we can see the figure, very clear figure is there. And we'll take the tilt flask, and in that tilt flask, we'll take the ammonium chloride and calcium hydroxide. And after the reaction, what is formed? It forms ammonia gas. In laboratory, we will get the ammonium gas along with the calcium chloride and water. So we can see that both we are getting ammonia gas and water. So we must remove the water before collecting the ammonia gas. So what should we do? We should supply this gas through this special type of arrangement which contain calcium oxide. We cannot use, we know that calcium oxide is also dehydrating agent. So by putting the star, it is also very important question. Why we cannot use to remove the moisture from the ammonia during the preparation of laboratory method of the ammonia gas? When we prepare the ammonia gas in laboratory, why we cannot use dehydrating agent like the H2SO4 or P2O5? Because when we pass the mixture of ammonia and water, we know that H2SO4 is a strong dehydrating agent. But what will form? It react with ammonia gas and form NH4 whole twice SO4. Ammonium sulfate form. You can balance it. Nitrogen is 2 here. Just put 2 here. Then you get the how many hydrogen? 2 3 is 6 and 2 8. 4 2 is 8. Equation is balanced. Similarly, when ammonia gas is passed through the P2O5. What we will get? We will get ammonium phosphate. You can balance it. Line 6. P4 is there. And then how many nitrogen is there? By putting 2 here, we get the balance equation. So that's why sulfuric acid and P2O5 we cannot use for removing the water or moisture from the ammonia gas. So in your examination, it may be asked if we can prepare the ammonia gas from the ammonium salt, but why we cannot use NH4, NO3, ammonium nitrate? Because it is explosive in nature. Second one, why we are not using the KOH and NaOH in laboratory? Because of their deliquescent. Third one, why we are using a particular calcium oxide to remove the moisture? Because why we are using calcium oxide? Because calcium oxide is a basic, it is a basic in nature. Because we know that metal oxides are basic in nature. So calcium oxide is also basic in nature. That's why it will not react with the ammonia. Otherwise, they will react with the ammonia and form other product. That's why it is very difficult to get the ammonia. So in this way, we can prepare the ammonia and we can remove the water moisture. Now, some other matter we will talk, we have discussed already, the laboratory preparation of ammonia by this setup. You can see the failed flasks there. And in that flask, we have taken the what? Calcium hydroxide and ammonium chloride. Then what we will get? We will get the ammonia gas, and that gas is must be passed through the calcium oxide because it absorbs the moisture, and then we will get the ammonia gas in inverted gas jar, and it is collected by the downward displacement because ammonia gas is lighter than air. Now we will talk about the preparation of ammonia from metal nitride. The first example I will take magnesium nitride N2N3. We know that the valency of magnesium is what? +2, and nitrogen is that? -3. Cross multiplying we get this one, and once it reacts with water we will get magnesium hydroxide, and then we get NH3. You can balance it. How many magnesium is there? 3. Just put in 3. Then count the nitrogen. 2 is there. Just 2. Then count the hydrogen. 3 to 6 and 6 to 12. Just put in 2, 6. You will get the balance equation. Similarly, when it aluminium nitride LAN, because the valency of aluminium is +3 and N is -3. We will get the AN. And if we add with the what? Water. What we will get? Aluminium hydroxide, and we will get 2NH3. Not 2NH3, you can balance it. Just count. First, you can balance it by putting nitrogen and hydrogen on that. In all these cases, we are getting ammonia gas. And this is the setup we can use for the preparation of ammonia gas from the metal nitride. You can see the round bottom flask and one thistle funnel is inserted, and through which we are using the putting the water into the beaker which contain the metal nitride. Then we get the ammonia gas, and then this ammonia gas is must be passed through this beaker which contain the calcium oxide, and then calcium oxide absorb the moisture from that, and then we get the pure ammonia gas in gas jar by downward displacement. It is very clear. So already we have discussed the preparation of ammonia gas. Now we'll talk about the solubility of ammonia. You know ammonia, like already we have discussed in the which chapter? Hydrochloric acid, hydrogen chloride. Like this, ammonia is also very soluble. So suppose in the setup we are getting the nitrogen gas, ammonia gas through the tube, and that gas, once it is dissolved in water, so we know that it contains what? Water. And once ammonia gas formed, NH3, so we know that the solubility of ammonia is very, very high. So it will dissolve, and rate of formation and rate of dissolution. So here rate of dissolution will be higher than the rate of formation. Means the rate of formation of ammonia gas will be less than the rate of dissolution. So what will happen here? Once ammonia gas is dissolved in water, what will happen? Here low pressure will be created, and then water start flowing inside the tube. And then what happened? Once water will go inside the beaker, reaction will all disturb. So to prevent this thing, that is called back suction. To prevent this back suction, we are using inverted funnel, and already we have discussed how we are using the inverted funnel, because it prevents the backflowing of the water into the beaker, because two reasons. It increases the surface area, and once NH3 is dissolved in water, what will happen? Low pressure region will create and it will go upside. Then after the formation it comes downside, and because the upside and downside, nothing flow of water will happen inside the tube. So this is called back suction process to prevent by the inserting inverted funnel into the apparatus where we are forming the, where we are using the chemical, either metal nitride or ammonium salt to prepare the ammonia gas. So by this way we can prevent. Now next method we will talk about fountain experiment. We will talk about fountain experiment. In this experiment, we'll take this stand, and with the help of the stand, we fit the one round bottom flask, must be fitted like this, and this part is fixed, and then we insert the one dropper inside it. It is filled with the water, and one tube, glass tube, will go like this, and that glass tube must be deep into the beaker which contain red litmus. Now, and this jar filled with the what? Ammonia gas. Once we squeeze the dropper, what will happen? What will start coming out? And one water will start coming out. We know that ammonia gas is a highly soluble in water, then it will dissolve, and after dissolving, here what will happen? Low pressure region will create, pressure will decrease, and here what will form? Liquid ammonia. And because of low pressure, that this red litmus will come out, and we know that when litmus will come out, it will react and form the red to blue color, and we know that once it change red to blue, it is showing that ammonia, liquid ammonia, is a basic in nature, and this is called fountain experiment. It is called fountain experiment. Again, I want to make you understand how it will, you will do. Just you will take the one round bottom flask, and one dropper must be inserted, which is filled with the water, and then one tube will come from the flask and dip into the red litmus. When we squeeze the dropper, water will come out. We know that NH3 is the highest soluble in water. It will dissolve, and it creates the low pressure region here. And because of low pressure, red litmus start coming out, coming inside the tube, and once it come out, it will react with what? Liquid ammonia, and it turn to the blue, and it will indicate that ammonia is a highly soluble in water as well as it is a basic in nature. So this is the preparation we have discussed by the laboratory method from the mini ammonium salt, and also we have discussed the preparation of ammonia from the metal nitride. And also we have discussed the fountain experiment. In next video, we will talk about some chemical properties and uses of ammonia gas. And then after that, we will start the new chapter. Till then, thank you and have a nice day, my dear student.